won't post this video. Alright guys, welcome back to another episode of the Rice Rockets here. It is actually quite nice out today, and I'm going for a little joyride before I go to the brewery out in Queens, going to meet my girlfriend and some friends, but I gotta take the long way just because I gotta do it. So that's today's video, quick and easy ride, let's go. Stop short of the sunlight, guys. It's pretty intense, my friends. So I'm not going to lie, I kind of forget how to get on the Woodside Highway to go south. I know how to get there for north, but... and we will figure this out. Together we will we will conquer this problem. you guys heard that. I scraped my peg. Hey, look at that. Pop my cherry, guys. Feel like a real man. I don't know if I can still say that in 2024. Googles, the Googleist of the Google. Man, look at that building. That's crazy. And it looks like they got a lawn up on the top too. That's pretty crazy. I bet they have organic, free organic salads that are grown in house. Or on roof. That's a pretty cool building though. All the I-beams and stuff, that's pretty cool. Wow. Craziness, craziness. Jesus Christ, it's hot. So I actually have a funny story about over here, totally random. what was that like? Junior year of high school. So for the majority of high school and college, I was into like rap and hip hop. Then there was a brief phase where I was into like punk rock. And I guess it was really like emo rock. And a bunch of my friends and I, we somehow, I can't remember how it happened, but we crossed paths with this aspiring band. They were called Beyond Hope Lies. They did a lot of like whiny, like I'm so lonely and you know I'm in love and being a teenager is hard type of music. But anyway, this building right here, the red one with the little circle windows, the scap. That guy right there. We shot our first music video there, and I say we, I'm not in the band, but I was their videographer for like a summer. And anyway, that building, we found that place because one of the band members, this guy named Chip, he was this Indonesian kid, I think he was Indonesian, broken English, tattoos everywhere, kind of like just a funny character, like he found his way into like different situations in life that the average person doesn't. And this particular situation was that he ended up being someone's assistant for his day job. And he said, hey, I got the okay to shoot at, you know, at my workplace, like come on over. And so we go over there, the band meets there. I show up, and at the time it was like a really down and out, it was a pretty shitty area. We all get there and we're in the living room. We go upstairs to what I presumed was an office, but and we get there and he's kind of just there. He's like, oh, we're almost done and I can bring you up to the roof and we'll shoot up there. And all of a sudden around the corner comes this woman. Now this woman was Jennifer Connelly. I had the biggest crush on her in high school, and she was just there, and I was like, holy shit, this guy got Jennifer Connelly to be in the music video. Like, that's insane. That's like a thing only this guy could do. Like, if anybody pulled a random celebrity out of their pocket, it would have been him. But no, so it turns out the woman that he was working for
was Jennifer Connelly. He was her assistant for, like, maybe one of many assistants. I don't know. But that's either where she lived or she worked. I wasn't entirely sure, but I was so, like, blown away. But no one else knew that this woman was an actor. Like, I was the only one. So I was kind of, like, starstruck for a minute. I was like, wait a minute. Whoa. What? Who? Why are you here? And I looked around at everyone. Everyone was like, what? And he's like, yeah, that's my boss. And I was like, that, do you know who that is? And he's like, that's my boss, man. Let's go shoot this video. And the whole time I shot the video, I was like mind blown. I was like, wait, what? How does no one else understand who she is? And that's how I met Jennifer Connelly. I don't think I actually said anything to her. I was so taken aback. I was just like, oh, hi. Which probably in retrospect was very strange on the receiving end. But anyway, that's my memory of this ride. Whenever I ride down this West Side Highway, I always think of that story. I always think of the time that I met Jennifer Connelly and that no one knew who she was other than me. Which was crazy. Consequently, the music video is still up on YouTube. It is still out there. Beyond Hope Lies. Wait, it was, yeah, Beyond Hope Lies, and the song was Catch Me If You Can. The thumbnail is a guy with a blue mohawk. I shot that thing. That was my first full thing I edited. It was in film school. Or applying to film school. I thought I was going to use that for my resume or whatever you call it. My portfolio. I ended up not going in that direction because it wasn't that great of a music video. Man, these buildings look so crazy. It's so much glass. Now that I work in construction, I continually think about the cost of glass, right? And if I was somebody who specialized in glass and was providing the glass for these buildings, I would be a billionaire. That's an insane amount of glass. It's also probably really difficult to get it into the city. Like, that's a lot of trucks worth of glass. All right, come on. Let's get the fuck out of this. I am sweating. Oh, there is definitely an accident. to do the right thing, and it's like, nah, that's going to end poorly for me. Oh, God damn. I'll post this video. Thank you. Oh my god, so many bumps, so many bumps. Guys, almost there. Jeez. Oh, jeez. Seen anybody drive so slow. Not the CRV in front of me, but the guy, the one two in front of me.
There we go, guys. Oh, I'm just gonna pause here for a minute.
Alewife Brewing, guys. Oh, quick ride today, guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.